We have a problem with transforming normals when using non-uniform scaling matrices. If we tried to transform the normal with the same scaling matrix used to transform the vertex coordinates, we ran into the strange situation of normals getting bent away from their surfaces. How to solve this? I'll jump to the punchline. What you want to use to transform normals is the transpose of the inverse of the model matrix. You could also use the inverse of the transpose of the model matrix. They're the same thing. Either way, that's a mouthful, and let me explain. Let's look at how this solution applies to each different kind of transform that we're used to. First of all, forget about translation matrices. We're going to be transforming normals, and translation matrices do not affect vectors in any way. For rotation matrices, the transpose is the inverse. The transpose of the inverse, in other words, would be the inverse of the inverse. This is starting to sound a little like Alice in Wonderland. To be a little more clear, if you take the transpose of the inverse of a rotation matrix, you get the same rotation matrix back. This means that for a matrix made up of any series of translations and rotations, you can use this same matrix to transform points and normals. This is because the transpose is the inverse, as far as normals are concerned. Scaling makes it no longer true that the transpose is the inverse, so we have to take special steps. If the scaling matrix is uniform, in other words, the shape of the object doesn't change, we can get away with just normalizing the normals after transforming by the original model matrix. For non-uniform scaling, where the shape of the object is changed, we must explicitly compute the special transpose of the inverse matrix in order to transform normals correctly. Or you can do the inverse of the transpose. I'm not going to explain here why the transpose of the inverse works. You likely don't want me to talk about contravariant and covariant vectors. See the additional course materials for more information. If you keep away from non-uniform scaling matrices, you'll never run into this mismatch and can merely use the modeling matrix for both position and vector transforms. If you never use scales of any sort, you won't even have to renormalize your vectors. The good news is if you use scales of any sort in 3JS, it will correctly handle normal transformation for you. It's only when you're using scales on your own that you can get pretty weird shading results if you don't pay attention. And you do want to pay attention, as while this is always the correct answer, it's costly to compute all the time. I've seen many a young programmer led astray by normal transformation. Seriously, back in the 1980s, before any book ever mentioned it, this problem was fairly common. Back then, we consulted for a hardware company, who will remain nameless, writing programs using their expensive graphics accelerator. And I mean expensive, something like $35,000, the price of a nice BMW back then. I found that the graphics accelerator had this problem with polygon display, meaning we had to avoid using non-uniform scales as a modeling operation. The company was more than a bit dismayed when they found out about this problem, since it's costly to fix properly.